To know my intelligent, brilliant, and wonderful online students. We started a series not quite long, and that series is very vital, important, and relevant for SSCE examination in West Africa, and is also important for science students all through the world. So I will be making you understand certain things today that you should know how to tabulate your table, put your test, your observation, and your inference in table. Now let's not delay further. Let's go on straight away into what we have. Now look at test. Look at the observation. Look at the inference. The test on its own is the things you need to do. The observation are the characteristics that are discovered from the things you are adding together. And the inference is when you see the characteristics, you will be able to guess or identify or know what is inside those things you have mixed together, for by their characteristics we shall know them. Now look at it. When you put Na2CO3 or NaHCO3 in a test tube and you add dilute hydrochloric acid in drops, what are you likely to experience? There will be effervescence. There will be effervescence of a gas. Now, what do you think will be the properties or the characteristics of this gas that will be evolved? Number one, since there is CO3 there, you begin to think on your mind that CO2 should be the gas that will be evolved. Now, what are the characteristics of CO2? CO2 is a colorless gas. CO2 is odorless. CO2 turns blue litmus paper red. CO2 extinguish burning flames. Look at the characteristics. Number one, colorless. Number two, odorless. Number three, turn blue litmus paper red. Number four, it extinguish burning flames. So if you have all these characteristics, you know that CO2 is present. But CO2 cannot just be present. That CO2 must be from a CO3 minus. It must be from a radical. And the radical could either be CO32 minus or HCO3 minus. Let's move on to the next slide. Now look at this. Imagine if the salt Na2CO3 or NaHCO3 is not mentioned. From the observation, that is from the characteristics, the gas is CO2 because of the characteristics it shows. That is just all about the explanation. Let's move on. Now, to confirm that the gas is CO2, what will you do to really prove that what you have done is CO2? You are going to add water. Water is H2O to the test tube containing the gas. You add lime water. Lime water, this is not the formula, but it is a signal to the formula. There is Ca here, CaOH, then bracket 2, lime water. Lime water is calcium hydroxide. Take note of that. Let's see the full slide here. Lime water is to turn milky due to the presence of the formation of calcium trioxocarbonate 4, which is insoluble in water. So the lime water will be turned milky. And what is lime water? One more time I ask you. Lime water is calcium hydroxide. It will turn milky The reason is when calcium hydroxide combines with carbon 4 oxide, it's going to give you H2O and CaCO3. And the color of CaCO3 is milk color. It's insoluble in water. So learn this, please. Learn it again. Learn it again. Learn it again. And don't hesitate to subscribe and watch the next video for comprehensive